Have you heard that Airtable recently released a new feature that has been highly anticipated? I'm talking about looping automations inside of the native Airtable automations so that you can perform the same action over and over and over again if you have multiple records that it applies to. Well, if checking this out is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Of course, Airtable is one of our favorite no-code tools, and that is exactly what we're going to be talking about today. But before I get into it, I want to invite you to join me for some automation training. If you are relatively new to automation in general, or you'd just like to revisit the fundamentals of automation, check out my free training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. I will include links below this video, and from there you can go ahead and get that training sent directly to you immediately. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of the video here. We've got to talk about the new capability inside of Airtable automations, looping inside of an automation. Now I'm going to be actually building a live automation here for the first time. I have yet to use this new feature and I'm really excited to jump into it. So let's see how difficult it is to understand. To kick things off, we're going to be rebuilding an automation that already exists for me inside of Airtable. Initially, I had to build it without the looping feature, so we're going to be talking about why the looping feature actually makes this automation even better and ultimately makes it easier to work with and just overall superior as an automation. So first, let's outline the existing automation that we have. We set up inside of our database here that when a record matches these conditions, specifically, the conditions are that a piece of content in our content table has reached the stage of publishing is in process, and the schedule date is on or after today, meaning that it's in the future. If these two conditions are met, then we're going to go about and perform a long list, as you see, of action steps. The first action step is to create a record inside of the production process table. What does that look like? Well, that record is going to have a name, a specific task type, if you will. In this case, the task type is upload the video to YouTube. This is all part of our content production process. And of course, then this particular record, this task, is going to be linked to the specific piece of content that triggered the automation. This is also going to be assigned to someone, so someone is going to be in charge of doing this, and we're also going to bring in the due date. So we have a due date that lives on the content record that triggered the automation. We're going to take that due date and plug it in here. We're also going to label it to a specific process, so this process is YouTube, and we can also look at the production process template. So this is a linked relationship to another table, and this is where the looping is actually going to be available for us because of the fact that we have records that we're linking up to here. So let's go ahead and jump into the data schema to get a better understanding of exactly what's happening here. Inside the data, what we're looking at here is the production process template table. Inside of here, you'll see that we have 24 different records, and each of these records signifies a specific task that has to be completed when we publish a new piece of content. So of course then, this is basically a task list, a template task list. This is why the new looping automation feature is going to really unlock so much potential. Because right now, if we decide that we want to add a new step into our process, well then I need to first add the new record to our template, but then I have to go back into the automation and actually set up that new action step to create the new instance. So basically what happens is this template here is just providing an outline of all the different things we want to accomplish. And then inside of the production process, we're creating a unique instance of each one of these different tasks using that template and then linking that to the specific piece of content that the task pertains to. So you see that there's a bit of a workaround here where we have the list of the things in the template and we're just creating them uniquely in the production process each time a new piece of content requires publication. So let's see how we can build this now using the new looping feature inside of automations. First, of course, we're going to open up our automations panel and I'm going to just create a new automation here in the bottom left corner. Now I'll name this automation update of task creation. Something like that. And of course, I want to use the same or the similar trigger to what initially started this automation. So for us, that was a record matching conditions inside of our content table. And those conditions were that the video stage was inside of the publishing in process, and then also that the date here, the scheduled date, is on or after today, to make sure that we're dealing with things in the future. So now that I've established the same conditions, let's go ahead and move on to the next step. I'm going to come down into the actions where it now says add advanced logic or action. I will click here, and I am looking for the repeating group. Here we are, the new feature inside of Airtable Automations. So I'm going to run actions on every item in a list. But before I have my list, I first have to find the records. So let's first go in here and find records inside of my template table. Remember, I have a third table that lists out all the different records that I require in this particular instance. So I'm going to go to that table. It's called Production Process Template, and I want to find all the records. So let's just set up a condition that says I want to find things where the name is not empty. Of course, what this basically means is I want to find all of the records in that particular table. I want to quickly pause here and point out that you might have various different templates for particular processes inside of your workflow. In this case, you might come in and establish certain conditions saying I'm looking for template 1 or template 2, depending on what the automation you're building is. Well, in this case, everything in my template table is what I want to grab, so let's find it all. So I'll just say, find it where the name is not empty, and let's test the action. Of course, we know that there are 24 active pieces in our template. So when we look at this list, we see now 24 different things listed in this. And of course, each of these different records in here has already been linked to multiple other tasks over time as this automation or the previous version has iterated. So this is exactly what we're looking for, all of the records inside of our template. Now let's move on to the next step, which is going to be using that advanced logic. I'm going to come in here and select that repeating group. And from here, where do I go? Well, I have an input list option in the upper right corner. I better find out what that looks like. So I can click on input list. And of course, I'm suspecting that the input list is going to come from the records that we just found in the previous step. So let's make the selection here and say use as list, which appears to be our only option. Now we have the option here to determine the repetitive nature of this automation task. So are we going to repeat for each item inside of our list, or do we want to build some custom things here? Of course, in our example, we're going to repeat for everything in the entire list. So we'll keep that selection and we'll test the input list. So what will happen here? Well, it's going to tell us, look, I've got all these different records. I found 24 different records inside of the search that we performed in the previous step. And now I'm going to perform an automation for every single one of those records. That is exactly what we're looking for. So now we can set it up so that we can add this action. I'm going to go ahead and, for this particular purpose, create a record inside of not our template table, but in our example, inside of our production process table. And now we just have to choose the fields that we want to bring in here. So if we were to remember our previous automation, we're going to have the name field here. And inside the name field, we're just going to use the name from our current item in the list of records. So I can come down here and just select the name. Now, remember that this is going to iterate, in our example, 24 different times. But each time, the record that it's iterating for is going to be different. So the name will be different every single time this automation is performed. Now, we can also add some other stuff. So who am I assigning this to? Well, all of this is going to get assigned to Eric. So he is responsible for this entire production process, which makes that really simple for us. We also have the ability here to link to the template item, which I was doing previously as well. And in this case, I'm going to come in and again link to the current item, but here I want to link to the record ID. Now, the last missing piece in our example was to look at the process. Now, the process, I have two or three options. Is this a YouTube process, a Kajabi process, or a newsletter process? I don't actually have this information that currently lives inside of my template record. So in order to include this element, I would first have to go back into my template and add the part of the process that that particular task template pertains to. In our case, I don't want to do that just yet, and so I will leave this process piece blank and just remove it. But let's go ahead and generate a preview now for this particular automation. So you can see that here's what it's doing. It's assigning it, it's naming this task, and it's also linking it to the associated task inside of the process template. That's the majority of what I needed to do, just missing that one final step that I mentioned earlier. This will require, as I mentioned, just a slight reconfiguration of how we set everything up. But ultimately, what this is doing for us is enabling us now to have a much simpler automation. Look at this automation here compared to the previous automation for the publication process, which included 24 different steps for building out that automation. In addition to that, we have one more bonus here as well, which is if we add new tasks to our template, then they will automatically be incorporated inside of our automation. So if we add a 25th task in the future, something else that needs to be done, all I have to do at that point is to go into my data schema, go into my production process template, add a new record, and that's it. Voila, I'm done. Now the automation is going to pick up that 25th record as well and automatically include it when it next runs for this particular process. I hope you got a ton of value out of this and that you start implementing the looping feature inside of Airtable Automations. It's going to save you a ton of time, as we demonstrated here, not to mention streamline your process so that as things change inside of your templates, your automations stay up to date. That's it for this one. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to drop them below. And in the meantime, keep on building. Sorry, I gotta get the energy up.